about a crash course in the space shuttle's external tank, shall we? The external tank is the big orange thing you see on the outside of the shuttle. You know, the one the bat was napping on. As the name implies, the tank holds the liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen propellants. Of course, it wasn't always orange. For STS-1 and STS-2, it had been painted white to help reduce solar heating and cryogenic boil-off. Although that was determined to not be that big of an issue, and leaving it the orange color actually ended up saving about 600 pounds of weight. Unlike the other components of the shuttle, the external tank is not reused. It's jettisoned about 10 seconds after MECO, or main engine cutoff, where it then re-enters and breaks up in the Earth's atmosphere. The external tank is of course the biggest part of the shuttle, and when loaded, it's also the heaviest. Its empty weight is 58,500 pounds, but filled, it's closer to 1,680,000 pounds. The liquid hydrogen part of the tank makes up for 395,581.9 gallons of the entire tank. The operation pressure is between 32 and 34 psi, and the operation temperature is negative 423 degrees Fahrenheit. So, for those of you who were wondering how this little fill drain valve of STS-128 could have just suddenly stopped working, please keep in mind that when working with these temperatures, it's very easy for ice to form blockages, making something completely inoperable. Yes, even in the Florida heat.